Welcome, folks, to WTF Wrestling. We know you tuned in tonight to watch Survivor Tokyo, but we're going to give you some wrestling action instead because we know you're dying for it.
Well, you had Ned Ryerson already.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm Jim Biggins with my broadcast partner, Mr. Wiggles, whom you just heard from. And Ned Ryerson is on his way to the ring here tonight. You know why Ned Ryerson is on his way to the ring, Mr. Wiggles?
I imagine he's got something psychotic to do.
Well, actually, the Skinny Wolf was really pissed off about what happened on our last show. And he challenged the champion to a match here this week. Yeah. So, obviously, Ned was... He was perfectly happy to give him the match that he asked for.
You could already put another tally in Ned's death toll.
Yeah. So, you know, Ned Ryerson out here tonight. He's our champion, folks. He will be facing Lick Joe in a couple of weeks in a what he calls a Pennsylvania Penitentiary match, we think. At this point, we don't even know if he's going to stick to that because his random tweet sessions have continued, and he seems to be switching back and forth, deciding what it is he wants to do. So I guess when we know, you'll know, but I don't think we're going to know until the night of the show.
Look at this asshole.
I mean, you got to give him a little bit of credit for being like the skinniest, most lightweight prick in the whole Federation and just calling out the champion like that, because he got totally punked last week.
What he needs to do is call dominoes.
I agree.
And that's waste his time and waste everybody's time watching to see him get his ass kicked once again, because he's going to get his ass kicked.
I still cannot get over the fact that his legs are barely bigger around than the ring post.
That's a shitty paint job on the front of his tights.
Yeah.
You can see
I wonder if it was do you think it was done by the same artist that did the eagle on the back of Average White Man's jacket?
Probably. Either that or they bought it from the same fucking shitty flea market stall.
Well, I think that those that's a decal on the front of his tights anyway.
You probably got to put them on every time it comes out or some shit.
Yeah. Well, anyway, the match is underway, folks. Well, Skinny Wolf, no. Goes for a lariat in the corner, misses it. Hits a back suplex.
With a back suplex, right? On the champion.
That's something, right? I mean,
that's better than what the ref's doing. What the hell's wrong with the ref?
Did you see how much he had to strain to get Ned over in that back body drop?
Yeah, because he weighs like... Ned outweighs this guy, and Ned's a skinny, like, businessman.
You know, can you imagine what would happen if he tried to do that to Man Mountain McGurk or Dickie Moe?
He'd probably break over like a piece of doll furniture.
Skinny Wolf measuring him now with a big knee drop.
Right to his dome.
I don't know if any of this is really affecting the champion, though.
No, here he comes.
Yeah, apparently not.
So now he's
pissed.
I think
Ned has said he's had enough of Skinny Wolf shit. Big vertical suplex. I think that cancels out all the damage that Skinny Wolf managed
what
to do.
What damage? Oh! Oh! He's just throwing him around like he does weigh 25 pounds.
Oh!
Good
That'll
Lord.
Give you a concussion right there, folks.
That'll
Elbows
give you a
to the back
brain
of the head.
Hemorrhage.
Yeah. Now the suplex coming up. Well, sad as it is to say, speaking of brain hemorrhages,
just beating him on the mat.
Well, I think Skinny Wolf. Yeah, Skinny Wolf is learning the error of his ways at this particular moment.
I hope he's learned by now. He's trying to get out of it. Oh my God.
Ned Ryerson with the lariat, folks, makes Stan Hansen proud. Three, that's it.
I think he angered Ned Ryerson.
I think he did, too.
Well, you fuck with the bull, you get the horns.
Now, that's the truth. Looks like we're going to get this choke toss suplex coming up. He grabs him by the ears and throws him.
Here comes
the lariat, folks. If you watch, you can see a shit log fly out of Skinny Wolf's tights right at the end. There it goes. And the count was academic after that.
What a waste of space.
Yeah, I I'll applaud Skinny Wolf's courage, at least a little bit, but...
He's
at least
an idiot.
A little bit. But
you
he
don't
was...
pick fights with dogs you can't beat.
Yeah. Ned's a proud champion. He's inviting the crowd to come into the ring and try to take his belt.
He's yelling at Jerry Lawler right now.
Yeah, what, Jerry Lawyer?
Yeah, Jerry Lawyer.
You don't want to get a suit. That's Jerry Lawyer.
Oops. What the hell happened?
What the hell happened? Is that cowboy mad?
Oh, I can't tell the difference. Is it Irvis or is it Cowboy Matt?
That's Cowboy Matt. He's got the rattlesnake on his back. What happened to him?
Who knows? Oh, God.
Oh, here comes Mr. Hilter, folks.
Jews are definitely not okay with you, pal. Don't even try to pull the wool over people's eyes.
We decided to give the champion and the number one contender equal time here this week, so Mr. Hilter's going to be facing Lick
Joe.
Are you
telling me Mr. Hilter's going to face Lick Joe?
That's what I'm telling you, yes.
I'm looking forward to this.
I figured you would be. Mr. Hilter, a recent immigrant from Germany. It bears some resemblance to a historical figure.
Resemblance? Hell, he's Hitler! Listen to...
And the dulcet tones of Kiss bring out Lick Joe, the new crown number one contender.
And he's apparently like, not copying Marv anymore. This is amazing.
Yeah. Well, you know, if you look at Lick Joe's face, he kind of looks like he had someone hold his face to a tire that somebody was gunning the car, you know, they just pushed his face into a tire.
Certainly.
I think he's been abused so badly in his wrestling career that there's really not much going on upstairs anymore. It takes him sometimes a little while to, like, have a lucid moment.
His lucid moments usually come when he kills somebody.
Yeah. We better hope, Mr. Hilter better hope he's not lucid tonight.
I hope he is lucid.
Yeah, you do, but Mr. Hilter doesn't.
I don't give a shit what Mr. Hilter wants. He's got the hell coming.
All right, Mr. Hilter. Well, Mr. Hilter looked like he wanted to start off the offense himself, but...
He's getting his fucking arm ripped off. He's chopping right in the throat.
Yeah. Lick Joe is known for those throat chops. Oof. Lick Joe going right for the throat, literally. Lick Joe is a known murderer, folks. He's killed 13 other wrestlers. And he can add 2 testicles to that because he just killed Mr. Hilter's ability to reproduce.
He hit him right in the gerbils.
Okay, and there was the dropkick, another thing Lick Joe is famous for.
Mr. Hilter
trying to fight back here.
Survival instincts are kicking in.
Yes. Oh, that was a nice roundhouse punch, but, you know,
I
don't know.
Who gives a shit?
Yeah, I don't really think. And an armbar. The Stuttgart armbar.
Yeah, that really worked.
Yeah, I don't think it did much to Lick Joe, really.
Didn't do much to Russia, either.
Oof! Lick Joe's like, okay, stop it with the fancy wrestling, Hilter. Lick Joe's set for the ride now.
Oh! Totally denied.
Totally
Nazi
denied.
Bastard.
Vertical suplex coming up here.
Right in the center of the ring.
Right smack in the middle of the ring. And a big elbow drop to the sternum.
The cave in his chest.
Another big elbow drop. You know, I notice Lick Joe hasn't gone for a cover.
I don't think he's... I don't know. Do you think he's trying to end Mr. Hilter's career?
He could be trying to kill him, for all I know, but...
Let's hope.
Clothesline by Mr. Hilter. That was kind of impressive.
Well, he's fighting for his life here.
Yeah. Well, Lick Joe, I think he could have gone for a cover after that dropkick, but didn't do it. He misses with the chop there.
Oh!
Lands the elbows.
The side of the head. Yeah, watch that side of his head where the bullet went in.
Only the Russians know for sure.
Well, and they got to put the plate in there.
Chops, throat chops, knife in, chops.
Oh.
Now punches, looks like to the
he
shoulder.
He elbowed him right between the shoulder blades.
Yeah. Lick Joe's brutalizing. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
I think he killed Mr. Hilter. The ref says it's over. Is he dead?
I think he just broke Mr. Hilter's neck.
Fuck me. Okay, DDT coming up here. Oh,
either
Jesus.
That or his head cracked open like an egg.
Oh, Mr. Hilter is not moving, folks.
Mr. Hilter's fucking dead.
I think he's dead.
His brain's
gone. Look, so he's already dead.
Keep hitting him, Joe. There you go. Make sure he pays for
he's
everything
he's
done. He's
already dead.
I don't give a shit.
Well, look, Joe struck a blow for freedom, folks. Jews everywhere are celebrating tonight if indeed Mr. Hilter's dead.
The free world in general. And now the banker.
Yeah, so now the banker and his tax man comrade on the way to the ring. Mr. Wills, have you noticed that Undead Miller seems to kind of lose something when he's around Count DeMoney.
Yeah, he does.
Have you noticed that? Like, it's like, if he's off by himself, he's fine. But when Count DeMoney is close to him, he just kind of becomes more of a zombie.
He becomes less lucid.
Yeah. I wonder if it's not Count DeMoney's control that's kind of fucking with him.
Now, we don't know he's controlled. He's getting paid.
Yeah, he's, you know, he just does everything that he's told without even questioning it at all.
So I do that with enough zeros.
All right, point taken. Undead Miller, like I said before,
he looks
having
like
a hard time.
He's got jock itch. What the hell's wrong with him?
He's probably got jock mold. He's dead.
This is true.
I mean, that's true. All I can say to that.
He should have
these guys are
going to
be taking on Maple Ape and Randy tonight. I'm interested to see how that goes.
I think they're going to stuff Randy up Maple Ape's head.
Yeah, they probably will. Undead Miller is a force to be reckoned with. Well, uh-oh, okay. Uh-oh. All right. I told them they were going to be pissed.
Hey,
I warned them.
Turnabout is fair play.
I warned them.
If you don't want to get your ass kicked,
he's throwing
don't stand
Undead
in the
Miller
fire.
Out of the ring now. They got to count the money down by himself.
They're going to stomp a money. Oh, they got a chair.
Papa Wrestling with a chair here.
What
the hell is...
What the... That's fucking Ralph!
Is that Ralph?
That's fucking Cousin Ralph! He's fucking dead, too!
Cousin Ralph is dead! Can we see if that's Ralph?
It's fucking Ralph! Look, he's fucking dead!
Move the camera over, you fucking moron!
That's fucking Ralph!
That's Ralph!
He's got a fucking bow tie and a white shirt on.
Where did he get the fucking tie?
Where did he get Ralph? He got run over by a fucking truck!
There's no way! He couldn't have gotten Ralph if Ralph was in that trunk, so who the fuck did we bury? Who haven't we seen?
Checking my list.
We seen Urbis.
Let me go through my papers
here.
Oh, God,
it's Mountain Dew Mike. Have you seen Mountain Dew Mike?
Oh, shit, we killed Mountain Dew Mike. Somebody find Mountain Dew Mike.
If anybody out there has seen Mountain Dew Mike, let us know.
Is he on the back?
I'm afraid we might have buried him alive.
Do we need to start sending out milk cartons?
This is Man Mountain McGurk, folks. Man Mountain McGurk's coming out for... he's the first participant in another six-man battle royal, as I told you on our first show. We're going to have a lot of battle royals because I enjoy watching brawls.
I'm McGurk.
Yes, everyone loved hearing McGurk's story last week, so I took the liberty of getting us another one.
Oh, good.
Yeah, McGurk was nice enough to give us another one. We'll get to that here in just a minute.
I love
the beginning of this match.
Still think he should be the president of our company.
He isn't.
Can't we just like take the title off of Ned and give it to him?
I think Man Mountain McGurk could eat Ned Ryerson and spit out his clothes, personally.
Now, here's interesting, because Patty and McGurk, last time they were together in the ring, they went after each other pretty heavily.
Yes, they did. I think that's the reason why they were both booked into this match again. They really put on a good show last time we had them in one of these. So, you know, hey, if you put on a good show once, they could do it again.
That's right. I think we're going to see another one tonight, because I don't think these guys like each other for some reason.
No, well, I don't
maybe
think...
Maybe it's two alpha dogs don't like each other in the same yard.
That could be possible. I would not doubt that at all. I don't know if Patty likes anybody.
Oh, Jesus Christ, and there goes my night.
It's one of your favorites, Galahad coming to the ring, folks.
Don't call him that. Don't call him that, because it insults every, like, fiber, every cell in my body rebels. I can feel myself getting cancer.
You're Hunter from the future here. Unfortunately, there's no fire or pyro around, so we can't see if he's afraid of it.
Or any talking boxes.
Well, we know he doesn't like them.
He also doesn't like hygiene or women.
I was kind of hoping he sailed to the ring on a dead pterodactyl.
If he did that, I swear to God, I'd come to the next arena and shoot him out of the air.
Yeah, I noticed Yor didn't get a title card. Did you notice that, Mr. Wiggles? I think we got a guy asleep on the button up there.
Yeah, probably, or... Oh, God, it's Irvin. Because there's Irvin, so it was...
Yeah, well, I've seen Irvin. Cowboy, by the way, I want to point out to you guys, you're going to see Irvin making that hand signal. That's not a 3, it's an E for Irvin. Because I had to ask him about it. I'm like, Irvis, why are you making a 3 sign during your entrance? And he's like, it's not the 3, it's an E.
Burning Rove. I've seen it all now.
That's how he thinks it's spelled.
That's how he spells it regardless.
Yeah.
My God. What if he kicked who was that asshole that was his partner a couple weeks ago?
Jukebox Hero.
What if he kicked that asshole to the curb yet?
Well, I don't see him around here, do you?
That's a good thing.
I think our ring announcer is just checking out Irvis's ass, and I'm not comfortable with that.
Look oh, my God!
He's looking at Irvis's
Jesus
ass!
Jesus H. Christ, that guy is a bigger faggot than Robert Faggot.
Yeah, just keep your eyes up, dude. Wow, that was
crazy.
Oh,
here he comes! Here he comes! Tapping my desk in anticipation.
Butterball was involved in a really vicious assault on Stilts Jackson last week, folks.
Look at his legs!
And they were both involved in a really vicious assault on one of our referees.
Who gives a fuck about the ref? Look at his fucking legs!
I personally don't care about the ref either. He's a dumb shit. I hope he gets fucking DDT'd to death by Lick Joe or something eventually.
He might get it from Butterball.
Yeah, he might if he keeps fucking with Butterball. This is a mean individual, folks.
Half of an individual.
If anger were measured in height, the little son of a bitch would be 12 feet tall.
Speaking of Stilts Jackson.
We booked Stilts in this, too. We figured
this
that
is
they
not going to be pretty.
We figured they would want a chance to get back at each other after last week, and they both jumped at the chance. From what
well,
I understand,
Stilts
in our
have
big
to
show...
Jump. He can touch it from the floor.
From what I understand, in our big show in a couple weeks, Stilts and Butterball are going to go at it in some kind of match, but they keep saying they want, like, AK-47s and shit in the match. So we're having to negotiate what the stipulations will be.
I have a question. Is Stilts, like, his jersey he's got on here, is this homemade?
It looks homemade.
It certainly looks homemade to me.
Well, those are the Los Angeles Lakers colors. Did you ever see Stilts Jackson on the court for the Lakers?
I've never seen him anywhere but here.
Okay, so it has to be homemade. In search of was he on?
Men who can teleport and fly? Because he's hovering over the ground.
I really don't know what's going on with Stilts' shoes.
I think he's part Jersey Devil.
I don't know. It's possible. It really is.
He just shot a three-pointer in the ring.
Yeah, he shot a three-pointer at an invisible hoop, and an invisible ball is still missed somehow.
Yeah. That's why he didn't play for the Lakers.
All right, folks. I promised you another Mad Mountain McGurk story. Well, here we go. Story time with Mad Mountain McGurk.
I was in Romania shopping for real estate. The people I was dealing with tried to sell me a plot of land that used to belong to Vlad the Impaler. I was pissed. I told them there was no way I could build a windmill on a spot like that. It'd be haunted. They told me to go fuck myself in Romanian. I had to look it up when I got home to find out what they said. I was even more pissed. So, as is my custom, I sent them an autographed picture of my ass. 2 weeks later, I got a fax from them with a revised real estate deal for a better plot of land at a cheaper price. I did not know that sending autographed pictures of asses was how Romanians negotiate real estate deals. I consider it a learning experience.
Man Mount McGurk, ladies and gentlemen. You couldn't make this shit up.
I love this guy.
Butterball and McGurk going at it, I think maybe... You know, I think that Butterball looks like what Man Mountain McGurk looked like when Man Mountain McGurk was like 10 years old. With beard and all.
If Man Mountain McGurk's mother had smoked like 12 packs a day and he came out stunted, it'd be Butterball.
Yeah, basically.
Irvis just laid Dave
Ryder
on the ground.
Just put the hurting on your... McGurk and Butterball are still going at it.
Now Irvis and Reb going at it. Oh!
It looks like Patty's not having any of Stilts' shit.
No, and look at Stilts', he's hovering! I want to know the secret to this. He pick up their shoes in, like, some alternate reality?
It's got to be his shoes. It's the only thing I can think of.
Because he's never not with them. He's always got them.
He's got those shoes on. Somebody ought to try stealing his shoes and seeing if they can, like, hover. If it's like Back to the Future shoes or something.
I bet you if he stole his shoes, he'd shrink down to, like, like this skinny 2-foot midget.
Yeah, like when Mario, after he gets hit from, loses the mushroom.
Pretty much like that, yeah.
Probably have the same sound effect, too.
It's speaking of midgets, look at Butterball.
Butterball's after your now.
Even though Butterball's... Oh, here he goes. He's going to beat the hell out of him. There you go. Punch
right
him
in the ear.
Punch him for all of the lives he ruined with his movie.
Nerve has just planted a foot right in McGurk's chin. That could hurt. That had to hurt.
He put him down for a two. Irv is something else. Get something else going here.
Pulling McGurk somewhere.
The ref's in the way like a dipshit.
Well, he's always in the way no matter what he's doing.
Somebody go over there and beat the ref. Big headbutt from McGurk.
Butterball is like a body splash on your... Yeah. Look at Butterball doing a body splash.
He's so tiny.
It's like your little kid doing it.
He put York out for a two. Look at him. He's getting
a roll
bear
coming
hug.
No, or Irvis just elbowed out of a baloney roll. It looks like Butterball.
There goes Yor.
Yeah, I think Yor's out.
Butterball just made him submit with a bear hug.
Man, I tell you, little son of a bitch has got some power.
He was picking Yor up off the ground. Well, look at Stilts.
He's pinning Butterball, but...
What is going on with the ref here?
I don't know. Patty, what's he doing?
What's going on with the ref here? What is going on? Patty's trying to molest the ref. Butterball,
I don't know what's going
on.
It's like, what are they, sharing recipes or something?
Maybe he realizes this is one of his long-lost family members. Do you know each other? What's going on here?
I don't know. Butterball's been pinned for about a 25 count. It's going on 30. What? Patty looks like he wants to kill the referee, but I don't know.
But
guys.
Am I in the Twilight Zone?
I don't know. Can we, guys, did we, hang on a second. I got to make a call.
Patty, what are you doing?
Guys, can we get, we need the DM. Can you please send, right now. Thanks. Now. Thank you.
All right. Hopefully we can get the DM out here. Okay, yes. Deal with this. Something's wrong with reality.
We have a fucking dungeon master?
We have to, in case this happens. Sit. Okay, here we go. What you just saw never happened.
Couldn't he have started it with, like, you're still gone?
Well, that would be preferable, but I don't think the dungeon master's powers reach that far. Hopefully this time, reality will not break on us.
There's a lot of strange shit that happens in this place.
There is a lot of strange shit that happens in this place. It's a good goddamn thing we got a dungeon master, isn't it?
Yeah, we need some... I don't know, I think we need more butterballs. Maybe we get the dungeon master to make two or three more butterballs.
I think that would be a vulgar display of his power, Mr. Wiggles.
I don't think so. Well,
Butterball's going back after... Look at
that!
Oh my
god!
Holy shit! Folks, Man Mountain McGurk is 400 pounds, and Butterball just pump-handle slammed him.
Irvis and Yor again.
I don't know where that little bastard gets his power, but...
Probably same place Dungeon Master gets his. Fantasyland!
Maybe it's
a magic ring.
We have a couple of different pairings here, but it's still Butterball and McGurk. We've still got, we got Irvis and Stilts and Yor and Patty. Instead of Patty beating the shit out of Stilts. Do you think these six guys realize what just happened?
Hey, you know, Yor and Patty are one letter away from a York Peppermint Patty.
The finest color commentary here at WTF, folks. We accept nothing but the best.
I try. Come on, McGurk, he's a midget.
I don't think McGurk really cares.
I don't think he cares either, but, you know. Butterball is a threat, regardless. I mean...
Yeah, like I said, McGurk's 400 pounds, and Butterball just hit him with a pump handle slam. That takes power. I don't care. I don't care.
Oh!
Butterball's so
running
laid
STO out
there,
McGurk.
Yeah. No, McGurk only down for a one. Stilts Jackson just did a Northern Light suplex. I've seen everything now. And Butterball's press slamming McGurk.
Not only press slamming him into a power slam.
Son of a bitch.
How did he not telescope his little baby legs?
I don't know. Or his spine. Now he's got him up again. Lifts him up. World's strongest slam there. Massive power slam on McGurk. That could be it, folks. One.
Is it two?
Oh! No! McGirt comes out the back door at the last second.
Irvis. Three
but
count.
Irvis takes out Stills. I didn't see what he did to him. Did you?
No, I missed it. I was too busy watching Butterball.
Well, Stills is a chump, so I'm really, you know, I could have spit on him probably and pinned him.
And maybe he like untied his laces or something.
Well, Patty was beating the back of yours head into the mat.
Your Irvis got you. Oh, there's a headbutt on Butterball.
Yeah, Irvis the pin on your.
A two count from a body slam, your.
You think he'd have a little bit more pride than that? Then again, he could be hurting. Ooh, oh, that hurt him.
He's gonna have a hernia in the morning.
I'm surprised Butterball doesn't waste throwing McGurk around.
It's supernatural strength.
That's a three count on your after that double team gut crusher.
Oh,
same thing Irvis and Butterball just gave to McGurk.
Butterball and Hamburger Patty. This is a food battle.
Irvis with the foot to the chin again on McGurk. And that's going to do it for McGurk.
Yeah,
this ring is clearing out fast.
Well, I
now,
think
Irvis,
time
shake,
might...
rattle, and roll on Patty. Oh. That could do it for Patty.
Irvis is cleaning house.
No, 2.5, but yeah, you're right. Irvis was cleaning house there for a while. This might be his night. But then again, maybe not. Double gut crusher on Irvis.
That's the third double gut crusher. I don't know what's going on here.
Patty sent into a headbutt.
Big headbutt from the...
Is that going to do it?
Small guy?
One. No, Patty out on one. I don't think headbutts are really all that effective against Patty.
Oh, he just laid him out.
I don't know what that was, but that was effective.
Oh, now he's getting double teamed. Come on, he's a midget, guys.
Yeah, I mean, look at that. Double team gut crusher. You know, it's got to be hard to gut crush Butterball. He doesn't have much gut.
He's sheer muscle.
Kick out on
jealous.
One. Look at this double teaming Butterball now.
He's the biggest threat in there.
That's probably why they're doing it. Like Patty's going to send him... No, he's going to send him into the corner, but Butterball...
Oh, laid him out again.
Uh-oh. Butterball looks pissed.
Irvis didn't want to... Oh, what are we... What the hell is this?
Double chicken wing from Irvis to a face buster. Now he's got the little bastard in a camel clutch.
But
it's sad that Butterball can't
like
reach
that.
The rope from there, isn't it?
His back doesn't even bend that well. Come on. It's like trying to bend an action figure.
Kind of looks like an action figure now that you mention it. Irvis blocking a suplex, responding with a snap suplex of his own.
The hell is up with Irvis?
Now, Butterball going for the camel clutch. Can't see if Patty's going to tap, but that seems like, I don't know, that seems like Mission Impossible to me.
Yeah, Patty's not going to tap to that.
He's not going
to
tap.
Oh, he just fell on poor Butterball. I don't want to say poor
Butterball taking a lot. Yeah, because, I don't know, I mean, he looks like a real bastard. Not STF.
STF.
On Butterball.
Look at his little baby leg.
Yeah, it's sad that he can't reach the ropes from there. Look how short his arm is. It's like 5 inches and he can't even reach it.
He's a gopher.
He's not giving up, though.
Irvis is
getting
just
a big rest.
Hey, he's just letting them fucking kill each other. It's not good since Irvis has been on fire.
Yeah.
Oh, no, what is this now? Oh.
Continuing to do the double team damage to Butterball.
Back suplex.
Butterball can't take much more of this. One, two, no, out on two.
Irvis telling the ref to count.
Yeah, he wants Butterball the hell out of there.
Now he's taking that on Patty because Patty ain't getting the job done.
Well, he should have watched his back.
He turned his back on Butterball, though.
Ah, bear hug on Butterball.
Come on, it's like bear hugging a child.
Patty hit him in the back and made him break it up. Now, back suplex on Irvis. Patty is not shy about handing out those back suplexes, that's for sure.
Well, Irvis with a neck breaker.
Yeah, reverses the suplex into a neck breaker.
It turned his back on Butterball
again.
Yeah,
turned his back on Butterball. That was a big mistake.
That's a knee. See him dance around without a knee. Or a hand.
Yeah, that's what he was doing, too. He was dancing around. Ooh! Looks like he landed on Irvis. Butterball with the body splash.
Big splash.
The midget splash. One, two,
oh, he three. Got him.
Now shot a Butterball and Irvis, folks.
Come on, Butterball.
Butterball's got him up. He's got him up for the power slam. That's it. This could end it. Butterball to cover. One, two, three.
After all that double teaming, they ended up both getting their asses kicked by the same guy.
Yes.
The little guy.
The little guy, the smallest guy in the Federation.
With his baby arms, like T-Rex fingers.
That was amazing resiliency on Butterball's part to pull that out.
What's this now?
Mr. Wiggles, did you turn the lights out?
No. What the hell is this now?
I can hear Butterball's music. Turn on the lights. Yes.
What the hell's wrong? What the hell's going on there tonight?
There's some. Okay. Did you just see what I think?
I didn't see anything. My monitor's going in and out.
Okay. Folks, here comes Zangief. He's coming out here to have a singles match with Adam of Adam and Steve. And the catch for this match is that the members are going to have their tag team partners at ringside. To make sure this stays fair.
And like it's going to stay fair with Adam and Steve. Both those guys are just classic cheaters.
Yeah, I know. But I think that's why Zangief wanted Biff out here. I don't think he realized that there was no chance in hell he gets a fair match without some insurance.
Not with Steve at ringside.
Yeah.
I don't know where that guy keeps hiding his weapons, but he gets them.
And here comes Adam, folks. Of Adam and Steve. These two teams will be meeting in a couple of weeks at our big show to determine our first tag team champions.
Oh my god. Think he likes baseball?
I fucking hope so.
Good god.
There, Steve's already getting into it with the fans.
He's already
that?
Yelling at the crowd.
This motherfucker's gonna snap and punch a fan someday.
God. You look like a deformed Val Kilmer, dude. Get in the ring.
Look at Steve out there pointing at him going, yeah, that's a real man.
Yeah.
Come on, cheer for him, you cretins.
You see, Steve's hands were in the camera.
Yeah, I think he was trying to grab the camera. It's a good thing we cut when we did. All right, folks. One-on-one match here that will have absolutely no interference. I guarantee it.
Yeah.
I mean,
I'll eat my hat.
And I will tape you doing it. Zangief with a big back body drop to start things off.
Yeah, Zangief is in control already.
Yeah, following it up with a big back suplex.
I don't know what the... See, now we already have...
on the apron, but I don't know why. He's not
talking
trying
to
interfere.
Ref, but the ref is, not even hearing him. Look, the ref is in a thousand-yard stare here.
Well, he wasn't... Biff wasn't doing anything. I think he was looking at Steve. Maybe
he was
shooting
he was
Steve a little warning there.
Well, Steve hadn't done shit.
It's a nice hip toss there by Adam. That's not going to be enough to keep pace with Zangief, though. Zangief's not going to... win this match with hip toss and another backdrop.
A big back suplex.
Yeah, back suplex. Not a backdrop, not quite.
Oh!
Jesus! What the fuck was that?
He just bashed in his fucking head. They did his nuts.
He hit him between the eyes like Goro hit Art Lean.
I did again!
There's
still much difference between saying even Goro, so.
Well, except for the fact that Goro has four arms. It's about the only difference.
Well, Zangief's got three.
Zangief now just punching. God, I saw Adam's head whip around on that last shot.
What's he going to do now?
Camel
Oh, my God.
All I know is that Adam had better start doing something in this match, or it's going to be over really fast. He's crawling for the ropes now. Of course, the referee's in the way.
The ref is blocking him to the ropes. There's got to be something in the rule book about this.
Yeah, I... All right, okay. Adam got to the ropes, but... I think maybe the ref doesn't like Adam and Steve even.
I don't think the ref likes much of anything.
That was a vicious Russian sickle, and here comes Steve up on the apron.
See, that's what having a good partner is for.
Ref's telling him to get down. Adam tossing Zangief Okay, you can see where this is going.
Yeah, but...
they're definitely going for a double team here. Well, okay.
Zangief is inviting it.
Steve is not doing shit. He did not take a swing until Zangief turned his back. Did you see that?
I saw it. Zangief went over there was like, I dare you to touch me.
He wouldn't do it until he turned around. What a chicken shit.
And Steve is just trying to grab the ref.
Side rush and leg sweep on Zangief. Adam's starting to get some offense in here. Nice lariat.
Oh, big elbow drop.
Yeah, but I think that chest hair works as armor for Zangief. I don't think hitting him in the chest is very smart.
No.
Zangief ducks. Shoulder blocks Adam down. What were you saying?
I don't remember.
Sorry.
Oh, my God.
That's how you fling somebody to the floor. Zangief going out there, and Steve wants no part of this.
Steve is still, he's like going over there with Biff.
Yeah, he's like, okay, well, I'll stay
here with you where it's safe. What an asshole.
Uh-oh, pile driver coming up.
Oh!
Well, I think that's going to just about do it for Adam.
He's gonna need, Steve doesn't get up on the ring.
He's
going
to need Steve's help to survive. Here he is. Here comes the cavalry, just like clockwork. The ref's telling him to fuck off.
Biff,
I don't think Steve's listening.
No, the ref's
throwing Steve out of the arena.
Is he?
Yes. He's telling Steve that... no, okay, he's not. I saw him point to the back. I think he was warning him.
And maybe if he warns him, that's two times he's had to warn him. Third time, maybe he'll get his ass kicked right out of here.
Yeah, I think he was telling him, you're out of here if you do it again.
That's twice saying you should have had a pinfall.
Yeah, because Adam is not doing a whole lot in this match.
He's getting kicked around like a turd ball.
That was a nice clothesline, but Zangief, again, he moves from the elbow drop right back in control.
He's beating the shit out of him.
Yeah, there's really no technical way to talk about what Zangief is doing. He's just beating the shit out of him. Mr. Wiggles is right on the money.
Oh!
Big uppercut from him. Okay, he's finally got some kind of it, and Zangief reverses it again. Zangief staying in control. Armbar now. Steve up on the apron.
Ref not happy.
Okay, that's got to be it. Yeah, the ref's pointing at the back now. Yeah, he just threw Steve out.
It's about time.
Well, Adam's got nothing left to save him now.
Oh!
Folks,
he doesn't have a headbutt either.
One, two, three.
He just took his head off. That's a preview of what you guys are going to get in a tag match.
Yeah, I was about to say that same thing, Mr. Wiggles. If Adam and Steve had better be ready, because this is what they can look forward to.
They better bring some kryptonite or something.
They better find something, a rocket launcher.
That might not work. It might bounce off that chest hair.
I think that they better do something between now and the tag team title match, or it's going to be a short fucking match.
There's that lariat again. He took his head off. I'm surprised his head's still attached.
Victorious here, folks. Adam's still writhing and painting on the mat. Steve, nowhere to be found.
He's in the back like usual.
That was a low blow, Mr. Wiggles.
Yeah, he's there too.
I'm not even going to comment. You're disgusting. Zangief with the win here, fans. Biff congratulating him. You may be looking at your next tag team champion. As a matter of fact, if you're going to wager, I would wager on them.
I know I would. Oh, it's fucking Lardass.
What is that?
Wait a minute. Lardass has found something.
Is that Cowboy Matt's briefcase?
It is. It's the briefcase.
He's running with it.
That's the first time Lardass has run in years.
He just ran off with Matt's. Okay.
Of course, he's got food sits.
Well, he doesn't. Yeah, maybe that's it. I don't know.
Wait a minute. Matt never opened it?
I don't know if he opened it or not, but that sure as hell looked like the briefcase.
Uh-oh.
Casey Jones on his way to the ring, folks. We've got another Extreme Rules match coming up here. We had a pull-apart brawl in the back after our previous show between Axel Stone and Casey Jones. They were not satisfied with the result of the match. They decided to do it here again on this show. They said anybody who wanted to show up and fill up those final two spots is welcome to do it. So we'll see who shows up.
Uh-oh.
I can tell you, I don't think it's going to be Ding Dong Daniel.
Nah, well, they'd have to get him an attraction first.
I'm pretty sure that Ding Dong Daddy-O learned his lesson.
I mean, probably the first thing he's ever learned, dipshit.
Axel Stone on his way to the ring now, folks. He was victorious in his debut match here at WTF, where he beat Duke Davis and Casey Jones and Ding Dong Daddy-O. He was actually very creative with the use of weapons for a person who's never wrestled before.
Yeah, well, you don't have to be a wrestler to be creative with weapon use.
Both these guys with extensive street fighting experience.
Like I said, we have more people who have declared war on crime and won in this federation than I've ever seen collected in one place.
Yeah, it's... I certainly would not want to be like a gang member or something here. Like, I just stay away.
No,
if you're a wrestler and that was your gimmick, stay the fuck away from WTF.
Hey, can we like hire Conan or anything like that?
That's not a bad idea. Maybe we can get him in here and tell him we can scrape enough money together or some coke.
That would work. That'd be great.
We can just put some baking powder in a bag and tell him we got coke.
Yeah, well, now we might get Kevin Nash that way.
Oh shit.
Here comes Mongo.
You know, what? I don't know. maybe they made a mistake by leaving those two spots open. Maybe they should have just went at it one-on-one.
There's a possibility, because, I mean, you can shoot this guy and he don't feel it.
He's less of a exactly. Who and more of a what.
Yeah, I gotta take a drink on that one. See him, Mongo. I'm
he
glad
doesn't
I'm
look
not
happy.
In there. He never looks happy.
We need to get him some beans or something.
Uh-oh.
Okay, these two are not Duke Davis and Ding Dong Daddy-O.
No, now you guys... Now you got a fight on your hands.
Yeah, now you got a fight on your hands. Now we're going to see these two get really tested.
This is going to be great.
Yeah, I... Marv ready to give somebody the hard goodbye, which is what he calls his triple power bomb.
Oh boy. Who was it last time they got like six of those?
It was Little Mac.
It was Mac, that's right.
Yeah, we haven't seen him since, by the way. So
Mac still must be recuperating somewhere because he got...
Well, you know, you're talking 6'8", 380 versus 5'2", 100 pounds. I mean...
And just getting slammed into the mat over and over again.
It has nothing to do with Mac's guts. It just has to do with there's physical limitations. And you just can't surpass those.
Casey's
the only one not backing down from Marv, if you notice. He's still in the ring.
He's the only other one that's crazy.
That's true. It's Marv and Casey are fucking nuts.
At least Marv has medication. There's no medication for what Casey Jones is.
That's true. The only cure for that's death.
Or solitary confinement.
All right, folks.
Ref just runs to get the hell out of the way.
Yeah. Well, at least he did something smart for once.
Mongo's just slamming Marv.
Not surprisingly, Axel and Casey went right at each other's throats.
Oh! Mongo just took off Marv's head with a headbutt.
That was a vicious headbutt. I don't know how Mongo's hat stays on in there. Do you think maybe he's got a staple to his head?
A staple or a railroad tie, something.
It has to be something along those lines. Marvin struggled to get him up there.
Oh, he punched him in the ear.
I think he's trying to rip the hat off.
He ripped the hat off. Maybe he'll lose his power.
I don't know.
Like still Jackson's shoes.
Anything is possible in WTF. After seeing the DM earlier, I'm pretty well certain of that.
It's like every day there's something new. There's something new.
Marv going to, or excuse me, Mongo going to Marv's eyes.
Casey into the corner.
Axel's punching him in the kidney. He's now in the neck.
Him in the back of the head. Mongo's really taking it to Marv.
Yes, he is. Well, it's Mongo.
Oh, there
we
go.
That was a nice reversal.
Big bulldog from Casey.
Yeah, Mongo, he doesn't appear fazed by any of this.
Yeah, he just wants a good brawl.
Mongo and Marv Well, it looks like Marv wanted to go out of the ring. I don't know. Nice. Oh, bringing Mongo back in.
Surprised there hasn't been a weapon gotten in this match yet.
Casey is like, he's got total bloodlust on Axel here. He hasn't even thought about the weapons yet.
He just went after his knee.
I don't know if these two hate each other or if they just, like, enjoy beating the hell out of each other.
Oh, there we go. I knew it wouldn't take long.
Yeah, you knew it was coming. What's Casey going to bring into the ring here? And it looks like a steel chair. Who's he going after?
Oh!
Axel!
Oh, my Lord.
God damn, he's just whipping his ass with it.
There's blood all over that chair. The first hit just splattered blood everywhere.
All over him. No, the back.
Oh, the chair!
Right on that fucking chair.
Casey's had enough.
He's choking him and beating his head on the chair.
I don't think he liked losing last
week. Son of a bitch. Mr. Wiggles, look. He busted the fucking seat out of that chair with that backdrop.
The chair is broken. The chair is in two pieces.
Jesus Christ.
Axel's wandering around. Yeah, he's a little confused.
To give Axel a concussion test. I think he's grabbing Mongo thinking it's Casey Jones.
And that ain't Casey Jones. Have a lot harder time damaging that beast.
Exactly.
Oh, he just...
Yeah, I was on that's still steel. Mongo just landed on it with that side Russian leg sweep.
There's a big bulldog on Mongo.
Marv countering a headlock into a backdrop, back suplex, excuse me. And for all those wondering, yes, there is a difference between the two.
Oh, he's trying to give Mongo cauliflower ear.
Well, good luck with that.
Unfortunately, he doesn't feel pain. Oh! Oh, Casey going for another weapon.
Yeah, he's going for another one.
What's he going to get there? Oh, Marv's saying
no. He's got a crutch,
no.
But Marv stopped him. Is that a crutch that I see down there?
No, that's somebody in the crowd's got a crutch.
Yeah.
Look
at Marv just beating the living shit out of Casey.
Beating the hell out of him.
Here comes Mongo. Yeah, I see a guy's trying to give somebody a crutch.
Mongo's going for a weapon. Oh, but he was stopped too.
Now
Marv's going for
it.
A weapon.
So Marv might get it.
Marv pulls out a table. Oh, Mongo just creamed Axel.
Yes, he did. Trying to keep tabs on both these parries here. Casey's choking the hell out of Marv. Got a cover here on the other side of the ring, but only a one count.
Axel hasn't been the same since Casey Jones took him down with that chair.
No, that doesn't surprise me. Casey's got the crutch. He just took it from the fan.
Oh,
he beat Marv with it.
He beat Marv in a crotch with it.
Yeah, but less than a one count. Even still, Marv's a tough son of a bitch. Mongo is beating the fucking piss out of Axel over there.
I have a feeling somebody's going to end up going through the fake announcer table.
It's possible.
Oh, another bulldog.
Yeah, bulldog on the floor. That can't feel good. Even if you are Mongo.
Looks like Marv and Jones are going back into the ring.
Axel just hit a belly-to-belly suplex on Mongo on the floor.
The cover.
Another lariat on the floor by Mongo.
Oh, yeah, he's just jumping on him.
The ref's trying to keep track of both these pairings, and it's not easy. Somehow, Axel kicked out at one.
I don't know how. Mongo going for another weapon. I'm not sure what he pulled out there.
I'm not sure what that is. Maybe a sledgehammer?
I can't really see. I can't see if it's got a head on it or not. Could be a kendo stick.
Marv was laying into Casey a second ago in the ring. Axel back out here with Mongo.
Oh!
He just backfisted Mongo.
Axel for a weapon now. Uh-oh, he's pulled a chair.
He's got a chair, and he's going after Casey with it. Casey bailed. That was wise. Casey with the DDT on the concrete.
On the concrete.
That's got to be it. Not even Marv's getting up from that. Two? Not even a two!
Not even a two, one and a three quarters.
What the fuck is Marv made of? And he bulldogs it through the table. I'm glad I didn't make a bet with you about that table going down, Mr. Wiggles.
Mongo had the chair, but Axel took it from him. Now he's beating him with it. Oh!
Cracks Mongo in the face now, and the knees with
Wailing
that steel chair.
Oh, in the face again. Marv with a big reversal.
Oh, Casey into the pole.
Oh, and again, into the pole.
How is Marv even standing after getting that DDT on the concrete floor?
Oh, what is this now?
Oh, he just threw him down. I thought he was going to take him to the floor. Trash can in the ring. I don't know how that got there.
Mongo got Marv with the... Oh, he just destroyed that trash can with Casey Jones' body.
One. No, Casey out on one.
A one count?
That trash can
is... It's a lid.
Yeah, it's just... Yeah. It's flat, folks. Axel just hit a grand upper on Mongo, but at this point, I don't know anything's going to hurt Mongo or Marv. Mongo out on one from a grand upper. I don't know.
What are you going to do? Even Casey Jones is only staying down for a one after you get a trash can rammed up his ass. Oh, my
Lord. There's another one, a huge uppercut. One, two.
Two and a half on Marv.
Marv kicks out. Casey says he's going to DDT Mongo. He's got him right on the trash can.
The remnants of what used to be a trash can.
One, two. Mongo out on two from, I don't know.
I'm surprised he got the two count.
There's something superhuman about Mongo and Marv.
Oh!
You know, it's arguable there's something superhuman about Axel and Casey, too, but Mongo and Marv are in another dimension as far as durability goes.
A big reversal from Casey.
Yeah, he saved himself some pain there. He's beating the shit out of Mongo.
Mongo ain't feeling much.
Yeah, actually, Casey are in control now.
If you want to hurt Mongo, you better hit lower.
Mongo reversing things on Axel. The big slam on Mongo. I believe it's Marv reversing things on Axel, I mean. A camel clutch on Axel.
I
don't know if he's ready to submit just yet. But he's certainly feeling the pain on it. No, no submission.
Oh! Just put the boots to the side of his face.
Marv's got... Holy shit!
He threw him on that trash can!
He just threw him... He must have thrown him 10 feet! That's a 200-pound man!
God damn! Now he's... Hey, Casey's just working on Mongo's nuts.
Yeah, you said hit lower. Well, maybe Casey heard you.
Two count on Axel. Uh-oh, see, this is why you hit lower.
Uh-oh. That's the horse punch.
Oh!
Mongo knocks out animals with that. One, two...
Two and a three-quarter count.
There's something seriously wrong with all four of these individuals. They're not normal humans.
I can maybe understand Casey surviving that punch with a mask on, but...
Now Axel's going after... to Marv's nuts.
Oh, and it was a sledgehammer.
Mongo's got it.
Oh, right in the back of his head.
Oh, and then in his stomach. Mongo just wailing on Casey with a sledgehammer.
Oh! He threw the sledgehammer on him.
Yeah, you'd get arrested for that on the street.
That's assault with a deadly weapon.
Yes, it is.
Marvin, some kind of twisted submission hold over there.
And Mongo acting like he's not even hurt. Claws Casey's eyes through the mask.
He's still got eye holes.
Axel seems like he's doing better against Marv. Oh, he's taking a breather. I can't say I blame him. Casey's got the hammer.
Oh, he's going after the steps.
No, the ref admonishing Mongo. I think Mongo accidentally hit the ref. Marv and Axel throw their weapons down to go at it with their hands.
They agree to throw the weapons down.
That's unusual. Marv with the cover on the floor.
Just a one count. Some a submission on Casey here from Mongo.
I don't see Casey Jones giving up.
Even after all this shit that's happened to him, I still don't. I think Marv just reopened that wound on Axel.
Yeah, he elbowed him right in the face. Casey with a reversal into a belly to belly. Looks like Marv landed on the seat of that broken chair.
Oh!
Somebody these men are superhuman. I don't know how they're able to absorb this punishment.
Oh, Marv is actually fighting back after getting hit with a sledgehammer three times.
Mongo wailing on Axel's face. Just now, Marv is crushing Casey's head. The mask won't help him there.
Oh, and he just throws him.
I don't know.
First.
Even for Casey Jones, one.
How does he get
two,
up?
Two.
How does he? How did he do that?
I don't know.
There's no physical way that he could have done that.
I don't know how he's still fighting. I don't know how he's still walking, let alone fighting. Axel's not getting up. Blood loss has to be affecting Axel at this point.
Mongo with another horse punch.
Bang. Oh, man. That could be it for Axel,
guys.
Counting? Two, three. You know, Axel, that motherfucker is tough, but I'm kind of glad he stayed down for a three count there because this could have got really bad after what we saw happen to Mr. Hilter earlier.
Yeah.
Oh, the DDT on Marv. Mongo going for the cover. Two, three.
Got him.
It's about goddamn time. Now we're down to Mongo and Casey Jones. This bastard, I don't know. Can he survive this?
Oh, dude,
now, wait a minute.
No.
I did not see Casey tap there.
I think he's passed out.
I think he's gone, yeah. I think you might be right. Anyway, regardless of how it happened, there was the chair shot on Axel.
Folks, this is what happens when you issue an open challenge.
Yes, it is. Big grand upper that really didn't affect Mongo that much. I don't even know how that's possible. Mongo's wandering around the ring behind these replays, and people are running from him. Let's look here, because I don't think Casey tapped.
He didn't tap.
No, he did not. He did not tap unless he verbally gave up, which I can't imagine.
Either the ref just stopped the match or he passed out.
Yeah, in any case, whatever happened, folks, Mongo's the winner of our main event this week. Holy shit, that was brutal. I'm really starting to like these Extreme Rules matches, I got to tell you.
Nothing like them.
Maybe someday we'll hire some technical wrestlers and we can have some, like, wrestling instead of guys like big elephants hitting each other with chairs.
There's no fun in that.
Well, in any case, fans, thanks for tuning in to WTF or whatever it was you were wanting to watch, and we'll see you next time from somewhere.